Hello and welcome. It is August 13, 2023. This is Cancer Update 49. It is also my round three, day four of chemo. So just to start off, I'll give you an update on how things are going, because as you might remember, day four has historically been my worst day. And I would actually say today that I'm feeling okay. I've got mild neuropathy and mild lethargy today. Zero nausea. My nausea is non-existent. So just to concentrate on the neuropathy there for a second. So on days one and two of round three, I would say I had moderate neuropathy. On day three, which was yesterday, I'd say I had moderate to mild neuropathy. And today I'd say I've got mild neuropathy. And the neuropathy is from a drug called oxaliplatin, which only goes in on day one. So that bottle that you see around my neck that I take home for 48 hours, that's got fluorouracil in it, which is not oxaliplatin, it's a different drug. So all of the oxaliplatin goes in on day one, and of course it has a half-life. So that half-life is wearing out from the first moment, which explains why it has gone from moderate to moderate, moderate mild, and now mild, and I'm expecting by tomorrow I'll probably have none or very little. So the neuropathy is under control. I'm also really pleased to be sitting here on a day four and be functional, you know, be able to do things. Actually, this morning I went out and removed a power steering pump out of my scrap Mazda. So that went quite well. So I'm really happy. The other thing is, when I had the bag removed, I had my tumour markers were given to me. So let me pop them up on the screen and we'll go through them. Now, I think I'm probably going to do this low, and I think I'm going to do it down there. So I think I need to be over here to be able to fit it on the screen. So hopefully that's given me enough screen real estate. So let's go through. Sorry, that probably sounded really bad. That was the laptop scraping on the table. Let's go through the CA19-9. So it's continued to go down, and it's going down quite rapidly. So after round one, you'd see there it was 2,798. It's now down to 2,255. I do want to point out what the chemo-oncologist said to me, which is part of the reason that number is dropping is because I'm having my ascites drained. And you'll notice if you look at those figures on the left, between diagnosing and baseline, I went from 3,900 to 3,193. Now, I didn't have any chemo in between diagnosing and baseline. What I did have was ascites drains. So that's an indicator to you that you're actually seeing two things in that figure. What you're seeing is how my draining of my ascites is going. You're also seeing how the chemotherapy is going. The important thing is that line needs to keep dropping. You can see the normal range for a CA19-9 is less than 37 units per milliliter, 37. And even at the moment on my last reading, I have 2,255. So I am very, very much above normal, but I'm also very much down on where I started. So we are heading in the right direction. We just need to keep going there. If we look at the CEA number, my CEA from the bloods taken the other day, it was 42.9, which is a big drop from the 46.5 that it was after round one. So that is a true indicator, because that's nothing to do with my ascites. That's to do with the, I'll see if I can remember what it is, carcinoma something or other antigen. I'll write down the definition to CEA just here. That there is what it stands for. But as I remember it, what it means is the amount of new carcinoma being generated by the body. So the fact that I've gone down from 46.5 to 42.9 means my body is generating less cancer cells at the same time as I'm killing off cancer cells. So that has to be a good thing. So I'm really, really pleased that those numbers are heading in the right direction. So there you go. I'll take that off the screen now so I can move back into a normal position. So essentially, I'm quite happy. The numbers are heading all in the right direction. I'm feeling better. I'm able to better manage the side effects like the neuropathy and the nausea and the lethargy. Like I'm starting to get ways to manage all of those things. And so far, like I'm pretty early in round three, but I'd say round one was relatively hard. Round two was a bit easier. And so far round three is a bit easier as well. So I'm doing okay. I'm going all right. Yeah, I'm going to keep going. So that's probably all I'll say today, except to say that silence is golden, but duct tape is silver. So I think there's something in that for all of us. And the other thing, of course, is we have to remember Sarah Pogg's famous words: be kind and make good choices. I'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.